growing up in the desert gave me a special appreciation for deserts and also just how much is sort of hidden beneath the surface. So I think so often we look out at these desert landscapes and we're like, oh, this is kind of a barren wasteland. But the more you take sort of a pause and a step back and start to look at what's around you, the more you realize just how much there is and how much diversity is contained there. One of the things about California, and particular California deserts, is there's so many different kinds of scorpions that are found nowhere else on Earth. There's California scorpions unique to different parts of the Mojave or different parts of the Inyo Desert, or scorpions that are just living on the sand dunes, or scorpions that are just living in the salt flats, or scorpions that are found on the desert kind of in between those. And there's even scorpions that are just found in the cliffs. So super unique, super diverse, and really, really abundant. For me, what that abundance means is that scorpions are really important predators. They're keeping a really important check on the balance of these very delicate ecosystems. Here at the Academy, we have one of the most well-constructed scorpion collections of anywhere in the world, especially for California. We're able to rely on this collection to really understand not only how scorpions have changed through time, how their distributions have shrank or perhaps expanded as a result of human development and climate change, but also some of these collections give us clues about new species that have yet to be formally documented by science. There's such incredible diversity because they're not just one kind of scorpion doing one kind of thing in the world. There's all kinds of different scorpions doing all kinds of different things and really eking out a living in every sort of nook and cranny that they can possibly occupy.